We'd like to call the health committee meeting to order. For previous business, can I get a motion to approve the previous meeting minutes by Ally? Second by Lynn, all in favor?
Aye.
Under current business, authorizing an agreement with psychiatric group of Albany regarding psychiatric services. Good evening. Sure, Donna, how are you?
Very well, thank you.
Just a brief explanation, it's just an extended contract extension, correct?
Yes. I'm here with my deputy director, Sue Daly, and my fiscal director, Kelly Roberts, you've met before. We're here to ask for a one-year contract extension with our psychiatric group of Albany. I guess I could just summarize that this is a contract with 10 medical professionals. They provide services to over 850 patients, and it averages about 220 hours of medical services a week. We're requesting a year extension because we think the terrain is changing enough with bail reform and other things in the system that to ask for more years at this point is not responsible. But we will probably be coming back to you next year with more definitive data for a more extended contract.
You think your numbers at the jail, your intake will go up or down? I see with the bail reform it will go down, but with the intake of the homeless?
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, we have 150 plus inmate patients in our jail. And you've heard me say before that the community hospitals aren't doing their share and they end up being in the jails, and we stabilize and we treat. We're concerned about bail reform because those people may not end up either in the hospitals or in the jails. Having said that, though, we don't know how it's going to play out, and more than a year of a psychiatry contract is probably not a good idea at this point.
Any questions from the committee? Motion moved.
Motion.
Motion by Wanda. Second by Mr. Hogan. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Thank you.
Number two, authorizing an agreement with Capital District Physicians Health Plan regarding the Clinic Plus program.
Yes, so you've also heard me in past meetings talk about the Medicaid reform in New York State that's moving towards a different way of reimbursing services. We believe that by 2021, there's going to be a fairly radical difference in the way of services being reimbursed. Right now it's based on a service. In the future it's going to be based on the quality of the care to a population. CDPHP, which is one of our largest payers, is starting to do preliminary agreements with local providers to pave the way for that change in reimbursement down the road. This particular contract is to serve folks who we want to keep out of the emergency rooms and out of the hospitals by giving them a little bit of extra care in the community, whereas before we weren't able to do that. And so we'd like to enter into this contract for $300,000 for the one-year period of fiscal year 2020. They will, at the end of that year, they'll determine whether or not we've met our targets and goals, and we hope that we'll have this extended on into the future.
Wanda?
Okay, so if I'm understanding, it says this is to reduce unnecessary psychiatric emergency department admissions.
Yes.
All right, so so is that to catch them before they go to the emergency room so that they know they have something else available to them? And
well, there's two edges of this, and this is part of the Medicaid redesign from 2011 that Governor Cuomo put out. The goal is to have a 25% reduction in overall emergency room hospital admissions. So yes, we see people who have had multiple hospital admissions but no treatment. We're going to serve them to try to keep them from returning. And then we have other people who the goal is just to not let their condition get so bad that they have to go. So it's a double edge.
And so I had heard one time there were people that were in the hospital but not being admitted and sitting in the emergency for hours at a time.
Well,
days.
Could be days. Who said that?
Days.
Yes.
I said
yes, days.
I've heard
correct.
Days.
Yeah. This is a, you know, the larger picture here, and we've talked about this before. the shrinkage of state psychiatric hospitals has affected the community pretty dramatically. There are fewer beds available. The waiting rooms often get clogged up with patients with mental health challenges. And, yeah, we're trying to bolster the services in the community so that doesn't happen. But you're exactly right. It could be hours or days where people are sitting in emergency rooms and then shipped to hospitals that are not even in our county.
I have actually an example of that with right now, the community police office, yeah.
It's particularly challenging when it's children.
Any questions?
Motion.
Ally, second by Wanda, all in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Coming, Mr. Chairman.
Thanks,